cooler things that we have here that we never had the opportunity to have anywhere else that we've lived is the chickens. That was one of the very first things that we actually bought when we moved here. If memory serves, I think that we knew the closing date and we went on
Well, I originally just wanted a handful of chickens, five or six, but Shane went ahead and I believe he got
15 was the minimum.
Yeah, and then you got like a one free chicken.
Yeah, it was 15 minimum.
Sure, okay.
So and then when you made the purchase, I don't know if it was because it was our first time purchase or whatever, but they sent a one free exotic chicken, whatever that means.
Which turned out to be the nightmare chicken.
Which turned out to be the problem chicken, which is pretty funny. So yeah,
the children will be in therapy for that. That's how you can tell you live on a farm.
We ended up getting the chickens. I never had chickens in my whole life. We got them, and it was August, so it was nice and warm, so we didn't have much to worry about as far as...
But we ordered them without any thought into it, so we had nowhere to put them, no coop.
Yeah, we didn't have anything.
We bought a kid's swimming pool, what they lived in for a while. In our living room, I believe.
No, they lived in the garage.
Oh, you're right, we did put them in the garage.
Yeah, they were in the garage. In the pool, I put chicken wire around it. I think at first I put cardboard around it.
We tried that, that was a mess.
And that didn't work. And then we ended up putting chicken wire around it. And I think out of those 15 plus the exotic one, I think we only lost one bird like the first week. And then we ended up putting them in the one wing of the barn, 6 weeks old when we moved them out there. And I had only put chicken wire up like 4 feet high to separate them from basically the main part of the barn. And I put the chicken wire up, we left them for the night. And before I went to work the next day, I went out there to check on them.
Oh, and there was a couple and on top.
All of them were sitting on top of the chicken wire. At any time, they could have just hopped right over the chicken wire. At that time, the doors on the front of the barn, there was no bottom on it. There was like about a 6-inch gap. They could have just left if they had wanted to. One of my coworkers at work grew up on a farm, and I quickly went and asked him, do I have anything to worry about? And I remember him saying, like, do they have food in there? And I said, yeah, they have food. He goes, they won't leave. I got home, they were all in there. But I think it was shortly after that that we ended up getting the chicken coop.
Converted
into it and fully, nesting boxes and roosting posts and the whole thing. They were all supposed to be hens, and we ended up with one rooster, who we still have. We call him Big Fat Chicken. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure if I named him that or the kids named him.
The kids did.
He's a barred rock?
I believe so.
Yeah, I think he's a barred rock. So some of our chickens have been with us the whole time. They're coming up on Big Fat Chickens, coming up on 5 years old. I think the learning curve on chickens is really weird.
I think a lot of people worry about chickens, like how they're going to survive the winter, and that's pretty much a non-issue if you have shelter. They just need shelter. You don't need to heat it. You don't need to freak out about how warm they are. They just won't go outside if they're cold. The only thing I'd say watch out for is don't put water in there in the winter. But it seems like everyone's biggest worry is, well, what do you do to make them survive the winter? Do you heat your whole barn? Do you do this or that? No, you don't need to.
Right, and I was just gonna say that that's actually probably the biggest mistake I've made. It was the first year I tried to seal the barn up really tight to make it so it was warmer. We made sure that they had water. We got a little water heater. We got, made sure they had food. Because I had sealed the barn up so tight, what we ended up doing was a lot of the chickens that first year ended up getting frostbite mm-hmm. on their combs. Mm-hmm. And because of the humidity inside of the coop.
Now we put the water outside with the heated water thing so it doesn't freeze.
Right. So now we ended up figuring out that if you use like the heated dog dish, that works the best for them outside.
The other thing is the type of birds you want. We were real concerned about them flying away when we first got them, so we got less flighty birds. But years since, we've gotten other ones, like our amber lynx. They like to go up high. They still will go up on top of the chicken fence, but they won't leave. They're more of a flighty bird. We even thought about clipping their wings, which quite honestly you don't need to do either. They always come home as long as...
Yeah, we've never done that.
No,
sorry. Yeah, the new leghorns, they can fly. Yesterday when I was out there, two of them flew across the yard like pheasants.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, that's
really, still come back.
Yeah, they don't go, they really don't go anywhere.
Right.
I mean, we, for the most part, we've let our chickens free range wherever they want. You know, obviously we have a bigger property than a quarter acre suburban lot. I would say they stay probably within 100 feet of the barn all the time, regardless of where, what time of day it is or where they go. They're always within basically eye shot of the barn.
Mm-hmm.
Then one of the other things that I did, and I can't even remember where I saw this, was bell training them to come back to the barn.
Yeah, that works really well too.
Yeah, which was really simple. We bought a bell, a decorative bell, mounted it to the side of the coop, and I'd go out there and feed the chickens treats.
When ringing the bell?
And just sit there and ring the bell the whole time that they were enjoying their treats. And I think after maybe about the third time, I can walk out there any time of the day, ring the bell, and all of them will instantly come around.
Chickens are fairly smart.
Yeah, they are smart. That whole myth of them being dumb.
No, they really aren't. They're pretty smart animals.
I think they're pretty trainable.
Oh, for sure.
I think that if we wanted to have them do all kinds of silly chicken tricks, we probably wouldn't have too much trouble training them, just as long as you got a bag of treats right there.
And the one thing about chickens too, as soon as you have them, especially in Minnesota and like South Dakota, a lot of people don't want to keep them over the winter, so we get a lot of free ones. I've had a lot of people just be like, hey, can we drop our chickens off because we only want them in the summer, which is actually kind of nice because then you get a free chicken who's a good egg layer because they want them when they're small and cute, and then they want to get rid of them when they actually start laying the eggs, but they don't want to take care of them because for some reason everyone thinks winter is like death to a chicken.
Right. Yeah, we've probably half our chickens were given to us. And then out of that, the other thing that we started doing this year for the first time was we bought like a little chicken incubator and started making a bunch. And that was, I don't even know how many we made, at least a dozen.
But that was really fun. The kids really enjoyed that, watching that whole process. So if you're a homeschool person, that's a good thing to teach life cycle too. Yeah. And it's a fairly cheap thing to do. I'm pretty sure you can find a local farmer who'd be willing to give you fertilized eggs. Because I would like to continue to incubate them.
Right. Yeah, and that's really exciting. And then
an incubator is fairly cheap, and they last a long time, and they're not too complicated once you remember to take the rollers out.
Yes, that was kind of a pickle the first time through. I didn't take the rollers out.
Learning curve.
I'm excited about the leghorn being a rooster. That way we can call him Foghorn. If you don't care about landscaping, chickens are great. If you do care about landscaping, that's going to be a problem.
Yeah, they do nest into things.
I put mulch all the way around all of the apple trees, and it looked absolutely beautiful for about 4 hours.
Yeah.
As soon as the chickens found it, they spread this little tight circle of mulch that was right around the trees into about a 7 foot wide circle of mulch that got spread everywhere and was a complete disaster. And so
they had fun doing it, though.
They did have fun doing it, but you live and learn. So yeah, we ended up getting the chickens. I never had chickens in my whole life. I saw them before. I went to petting zoos.
I was just gonna say, I've never seen a chicken.
A hatchery. Murray, I think it's Murray McMurray. Whatever.
It's Murray McMurray.
I think it's Murray McMurray.
McMurray's hatchery.
No, it's Murray McMurray.
I'm sure it's McMurray's hatchery.
So, whatever.